Hi, this is Ashok Gurupati, Product Manager, Adobe Analytics. In this video, I'm going to lend you a brief overview of Adobe Analytics Dashboards, our brand new mobile app intended for execs and business users. If you've ever felt the need for anytime, anywhere access to insights from Adobe Analytics, Dashboards has you covered. You can use the app, available for both Apple and Android devices, to view scorecards you create or those that have been shared with you to drive on-demand decision-making. Once you have installed the app from either App Store, you can log into it using your Adobe Analytics credentials. If you do not yet have an Analytics login, you can reach out to your Analytics team and have one set up for you. The initial walkthrough is intended to lend you a brief glimpse of the features you can expect in the app. Scorecards are a collection of key metrics that will need to be created on and shared from Analytics' desktop UI. You can click through key metrics curated onto scorecards to get to a drill-in view for additional context. And you can also apply filters to a scorecard to produce a specific view of your business that might be more meaningful depending on the questions you're seeking to answer. You can then click Sign In to log in using your Adobe Analytics credentials. The app supports both Adobe IDs and single sign-on depending on what your company employs. Once you've entered your email ID, you would choose the ID type. I'm going to choose personal since mine's an Adobe ID, but if you have been set up with single sign-on, you would choose the company or school account option on the screen. You then enter your password, or if you're like me, use a password manager to do it for you. If it's the first time you're logging in or you've logged out and are trying to get back in, you will be asked if you would like to enable biometric authentication. Choosing yes here would mean you can use Face ID or fingerprint recognition to log into the app starting the next time. Also, if it is the first time you're logging in, you will be asked to choose your analytics login company. This is the analytics instance you would access your scorecards under. Most users would probably only have one or maybe two companies they're entitled to. And if you're unsure of which company you should select, please contact your analytics team or the person that created and shared the scorecard with you. Once I select my login instance, I am taken to my home screen. And listed here are all the scorecards that have either been created by me or have been shared with me. If no scorecards have been shared with you, you will see a note displayed saying as much, and that you will need to contact your analytics team to have one created and shared with you. So, to reiterate, the need for valid analytics credentials and a scorecard created and shared from the desktop instance of Adobe Analytics are pretty much the only two prerequisites for you to get started on the app. I can sort this list by either alphabetical or in the order in which these scorecards were last modified. I then select the scorecard I'd like to view and would land on the key metrics screen. Each scorecard is a collection of key metrics laid onto these tiles. Each tile displays the current reading of the metric and the percentage uptick or downtrend that the metric has witnessed relative to the comparison time range. The trend line within each tile is intended to lend you a glimpse into the current performance of the metric in blue relative to how the metric fared over the comparison date range in gray. I see that the scorecard is set to compare my key metric performance spanning April to June this year with that between Jan and March earlier this year. I can, if I wanted, pick from a slew of date range presets starting from the day bucket all the way to a year. Let's say I wanted to compare my key metric performance this month relative to that during last month. I select those ranges, click Done, and have the scorecard reanimate based on the ranges I just selected. You can click into each of these tiles for a drill-in view for additional context. Say the page views metric catches your eye and you'd like to know what led to the uptick in the metric this month since we just changed the date range. I can click into page views for a more detailed breakdown and a trend line with additional helpful context. I can pick from a list of breakdowns that the creator of the scorecard added to the drill-in view. For instance, this scorecard lets me break down my key metric by either country or product or the referring domain. Let me pick referring domain. What that does is display a table with my top referring domains. The column, again, is page views that each of these referring domains contributed. I can see that we have been very successful in attracting users from the Yahoo and Google domains. I can thumb over the trend line for a view of the key metric across discrete points in time. It is worth noting here that the numbers you see here correspond to identical time periods across the ranges you're comparing. If you recall, I selected this month compared to last month from the date range presets earlier. What that does is compare page views we've had so far this month to the same period last month. For instance, suppose today is May 13th. Then the numbers I see up there correspond to page views this month as of May 13th compared to page views last month as of April 13th. So we are essentially comparing apples with apples. I can also apply filters to the scorecard for a more granular view of these metrics. These options, again, were curated for you by the creator of the scorecard. You can click on the filter and choose from the options available to you for a different view of these metrics. I can switch to, say, my gold customers, and the scorecard would reanimate to display the key metrics with the gold customer lens applied to it. In this way, the same underlying set of key metrics can offer a rich array of combinations that can combine to lend you a really powerful but supremely intuitive view of the state of your business. If you were wondering what kind of user preferences you would be able to choose from, you can go back to the home screen, click the gear icon, and you will see a bunch of options. You can, for instance, switch between login instances and Experience Cloud orgs you have access to in case you preside over multiple business units spread across multiple login companies. You can click through preferences and choose from some really cool options. Say you're a fan of the dark mode, like I am. I can choose the dark theme and have that apply to the entire app, including scorecards and the drill-in view. I can also control the tile layout and choose between the grid view, which we just saw, and the list view. The list view offers not just visual variety to your experience of the dashboards app, but also places more focus on the trended view, so you can get a hang of the state of your key metrics in one glance. Before I wrap up, I did want to show you another option under settings that would let you report any bugs with your experience or suggest an improvement you'd like us to consider in a future iteration of the app, or simply ask us a question if you're unsure whether what you're seeing is a bug or something that warrants an explanation rather than a technical investigation. You can also attach a screen recording or screenshots with, you know, each of those options, just so we on the Adobe side have everything we need to be able to help you with whatever you run into on the app. Thank you so much. I hope this was useful and would help you get started on getting the most out of both the dashboards app and Adobe Analytics. Thanks again.